So Houston, family, Bill, Jersey, and the Beach Boys, during Old Lang Syne. Amazing, amazing voices. And continue now, continue your songs that have absolutely rocked the world, and I mean rocked the world, and will always continue to keep rocking the world. There were a lot of songs previous to this, but here are the Bare Naked Ladies with their song from their first hit, The Old Apartment, and then going into the Big Bang Theory, which Ed Robertson got asked on the airplane by the guy who was doing the show called Big Bang Theory to write the theme. Ed put it out of his mind until he was in the shower one morning. The phone rang, his wife answered the phone and came into his office and said, Ed, there's a guy on the phone asking me to write a song for Big Bang Theory. And he said, what? And he ran out and wrote it in like 20 minutes. It's the most played song in the world, theme song for television. If you look now, the Big Bang Theory is probably on in 2 or 4 pack chunks on every channel in the world. So Ed Robertson and BNL, congratulations on the most played theme song on television. So there's BNL with Old Apartment, and then the world's most played theme song, Big Bang Theory, Bare Naked Ladies. Thank you. Bang Theory. There's a lady and a song we're celebrating. She did not win on Canadian Idol. But by the way, Justin Timberlake, Britney Spears, a lot of other number one rock and artists did not win the talent shows they were on. Her name was Carly Rae Jepsen. She wrote the song called Call Me Maybe. She did a really cute video in her garage with the door open. They were in there playing in the garage. And that got seen by Justin Bieber and heard on the radio by Justin Bieber. And he got his manager together, Scooter, and got Carly Rae's record around the world. And it's the most played Canadian song in the world in the Soul Can catalog. My song, You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet, which we played earlier, Mashed with a Who, I hit number one in 22 countries. Carly Rae Jepsen kicked me out of the ballpark with that. She hit number one in 25 countries. Australia, Canada, Czech Republic, Denmark, Finland, France, Hungary, Ireland, Luxembourg, New Zealand, Poland, Scotia, Slovakia, Switzerland, UK, United States, Austria, Belgium, Flanders, Germany, Israel, Japan, Netherlands, Norway, and Sweden. Nominated for 2 Grammy Awards. Congratulations, Carly Rae Jepsen, and all the team who worked with her on that song, that one of the most played Canadian songs in the world, Call Me Maybe.
It's an alright song, it's catchy, but it's just, but if Carly Jepsen was a little more older, a little more like, you know, not just a, oh, I'm just a female singer.
Heard a number one smash song from the Titanic, Celine Dion, My Heart Will Go On.